Mel Bracewell joins us now. Got to ask right off the bat, how's the relationship with public transport going?
Oh, it's going well? Great. Yes, yes. I've upgraded to Uber, so we're good.
Oh, yes. Fantastic. Fantastic.
You are coming to us hot off the back of the Melbourne International Comedy Festival. You're touring around the country. Your star is so much on the rise, you'll be in Aussie soon.
We will claim
you very soon, Mel. But how have the shows been going?
Oh, they've been awesome. I went very extra this year. I got this massive neon sign with my name on it, because there it is.
Oh, hello.
Mel Bracewell. You might be wondering, why don't you go Melanie Bracewell? They charge per letter.
No wonder you were catching the bus.
Yeah, exactly. But it was weird. I bought this neon sign and they were like, do you want a dimmer with your neon sign? And I went, that'll be fine. No, I want it to be bright. And then it arrived and it was so bright that it was almost blinding. And I didn't have time to order the dimmer. So the people who came for like the first four shows were just blinded by my name.
Sunglasses on.
Yeah, it ended up being like a good marketing strategy though, because those people went home and then when they closed their eyes, all they could see was Mel Bracewell. So win for me.
According to your Instagram, you were quite the social butterfly during the comedy festival. Mm-hmm. And I've always wondered about comedians hanging out. Are you having nice, serious chats, or is it just, I'm going to do a joke, you do a joke, back and forth?
We're just spending the whole time talking crap about you guys, you common folk. No, it's pretty casual. It's pretty fun. We go out and have dinners. I was struck down with COVID halfway through the festival, which was a nightmare. And then I came out and I was like, oh, I'm going to live it up. And I went to a restaurant. And the first night I went out, I choked on calamari at dinner. And I went, this will be a way to go. Oh, my God. I'm so sorry.
Take it back to the cheap seats, mate, as well.
That on my TV show and not your one. Oh, no.
Hey, so for all those people that stopped me in the street and going, do you pre-record?
That
was your answer.
We did not.
So bad. I've never done that before, but I was so relaxed with you guys. I just let it slip.
What happened with the calamari?
I don't know if you want to know. I was at a restaurant and I was with a friend who is one of those people who's not great in a crisis. And so I was choking on the calamari, my sort of version of Squid Game. It was definitely, I couldn't properly breathe. And he sort of went, well, what do you want me to do? He went, should I give you a pat? And then a waiter came over and they went, do you need some help? He went, nah, we're good. And so I just sort of had to pull it out. And then I went and did my comedy festival show. So it was beautiful.
How'd the show go?
It was great. I swore heaps.
I believe you. Apart from that, you've been doing the pep seats, yes, which is apparently on at a much swearier time.
Yes,
than this.
It really is.
And you've just kicked off season two, so congratulations,
thank
firstly,
you so
on getting second season.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. Yes.
TV, that is the second season.
No,
is
that's
very...
what that was actually my tactic of swearing in your interview. Is we're trying to get every other show cancelled, yes, so that you know we stream to the top. But yes, it's been amazing this year because of COVID restrictions going away. We can have like a real life audience. We've just had the crew laughing last year, which is, you know, you go from paying people to laugh to people you're begging to laugh. So it has been a bit of a change, but we love it. It's been so cool.
On the cheap seats, though, you do make fun of a lot of news readers, myself included. You've dressed as me today, though,
in a different variation
of the colour grade, it has to be said.
Appearance.
But do I need to be worried about this particular, the new season?
Well,
or does anyone else on the panel need to be worried?
That's the thing, is that you guys are quite good at your jobs. That's the thing, is we try, we
there's
go...
the promo.
So what happened the time you did pick on this?
No, we watch a lot of news. We watch everything. I'm watching all the shows at 2x speed to get more news in. Yeah. And it means I've just got a parasocial relationship with all of you, so I feel like we know each other very well.
No, you and Tom Cashman have done a great job on that show. Sorry, Tim.
And of course, you can catch Mel on the cheap seats Tuesday nights 8:40 here on 10 or streaming on 10 Play. Melanie Bracewell, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.